Please mute your mic, please. Can you mute your mic? Can you mute your mic?
You can start, Ms. Amani. It's okay.
Yes, Ms. Amani, may I add something?
Okay, you can add. Go ahead. What's your name?
My name is Shaima Muhammad.
Yes, Ms. Shaima, go ahead. You're welcome.
Thank you. I can say that why flipped classroom is important. It maybe increases the critical thinking and self-learning for students and build experience, communication skills, and cooperation among students.
Great, great.
It also many
thanks for your sharing, really. Thank you.
Thank you.
It makes
students reach the last stage of Bloom taxonomy, which is creativity. Yes, thank you.
Excellent. This is a good point, and we are to speak about it. Thank you, many thanks for your participation. We said that flipped classroom is needed nowadays because you're welcome. As you can see through the screen, this is Dr. Tariq Shawqi, the Minister of Education. Based on the latest statement of Dr. Tariq Shawqi, the flipped educational policy will be the main strategy of contain the main strategy of blended learning, which is the flipped classroom is one of its parts. Okay, so as you can see, at تعليم طبعاً عن مفاجأة التدريس بنظام الفصل المقلوب. Okay, and this is the student. Also, Mr. Lauren Anderson spoke about the same point before. But then in Bloom's taxonomy, he divided the Bloom's taxonomy into three parts, before class, during class, and after class. Before class, it's inverted here, remembering and understanding. During class, just apply and analyze. How apply activities, apply what you have learned, what you have understood, okay? Then the teacher analyzes, please mute yourself. Please mute yourself, Dr. Nagwa. Okay. Then the teacher analyzes what happens in front of him activities and the games he brought, texts. Presentations they make after the class, they receive evaluation and create information. They go and the learning outcomes are already achieved. We can find that in thinking of Bloom's taxonomy, there is a level of learning, traditional classroom tools, flipped classroom tools. Let's see, level of learning at remembering in the traditional classroom tools, we find that face-to-face lecture. In the flipped classroom, we have pre-recorded lectures, reading materials, and watching these lectures independently. That's what the learner does in the flipped classroom. And the remembering and understanding in traditional classroom, questions and answers. But in flipped classroom, it's so different. It's so different. Yes. These are for the learner. These stages or levels of thinking for the learner. Okay. What does the learner do in this flipped classroom tools? He uses reflection, peer-to-peer discussion, and collaboration. In analyzing, in the level of analyzing, he in the traditional classroom he uses homework, only homework. But in flipped classroom, he uses classroom activities such as group discussion and student projects. In the level of learning, of applying and evaluating and creating, in the traditional classroom, only homework or nothing. He does nothing. But in the flipped classroom tools, student project presentations, peer evaluation, and instructor evaluation. Okay? Also, in the learning pyramid, we find that the highest percentage of making benefit of learning is to teach others. Then, practice by doing, discussion group, and becomes the least benefit that learners can get from learning is through lectures, is through the lectures. And the earliest such representation leads to originate in 1954 book called Audiovisual Method. In this book, this learning pyramid model becomes the central of representation of this concept of flipped classroom. Students with large number, class with large number, this model can benefit them much more than the class of small numbers, okay? Because you just divide them into groups, they teach each other, and you just facilitate and organize them, guide them, give them orders and tactics to do before, during, and after. Benefits of flipped classroom. As you can see, that flipped room speaks the language of today's students, so they can speak their language. Yes, go ahead. Go ahead, who would like to speak, who would like to add? Okay, help busy students, struggling students, and students with all abilities, they can be excellent students. They can turn into excellent students, okay? Through the classroom, as they are motivated, they become more self-confident. They become able to share and give opinions, discuss. They get the courage to be part of the classroom. Flipping allows students to pause and rewind their teachers. On the contrary, in the traditional classroom, they can't do this. You can't stop the teacher every now and then and ask him to repeat. There is a time for the classroom session, okay? Flipping increases student-teacher interaction because once you are a student, sharing your opinion and engaging all the time and going through the different resources, so there is interaction between the student and the teacher. No neglect the students here, okay? Also, there is the two-student interaction. Real life differentiation changes the classroom management technique. Okay. Also, makes your class transparent. Great technique. It's a great technique for both the teacher and the learner. What is the difference between traditional teaching and the flipped classroom? Who can share? You can write your answers in the chat box. Or you can share, unmute yourself and share. What do you think? What is the difference between traditional teaching and the flipped classroom?
Yes, yes, Ms. Amani.
Yes, Mr. Ahmed.
It's the same difference between traditional teaching or traditional learning and learner-centered learning. So, traditional teaching, the teacher is the main focus. He does everything, he or she does everything. And yes, students are passive, just listening and memorizing. But in a flipped classroom, the learner does everything. So the teacher depends on the learner to study and then come to the class and practice. So here the student is the main focus of the learning process.
Great, Mr. Ahmed. So it turned into learner-centered process where the learners are the main focus of the learning and teaching process. Okay, who would like to add? Who would like to add? Yes, the additional learning, Ms. Fatma, is a teacher-centered talking all the time. Yes, So teacher talk time is too much.
Yes, may I add something?
What's your name?
Yes, my name is Shaima.
Yes, Ms. Shaima, go ahead.
I think in the traditional classroom, the process of learning begins inside the class by the teacher and the students. But in the flipped or reversed classroom, I think the process of learning begins before the students come to the class. They prepare their knowledge and their information and then come to the class to discuss this information with their teacher and with their colleagues and to practice what they learned before.
So they turn into active participants.
Yes, that's it.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Shaima. It's a great session today. Learners are better feel bored in the traditional teaching and it's a face-to-face learning. Yes, what else would like to add? Yes, Ms. Iman Hassan, flipped classroom. Yes, most welcome. What's your name?
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Mr. Ali?
Yes, Mr. Ali, go ahead.
Yes, in a traditional classroom, students learn at the class and they practice at home. But vice versa, in a flipped classroom, students learn content at home and practice it at the class.
Great. Thanks, Mr. Ali, for your addition. Okay.
Yes, Ms. Amani, excuse me.
Yes, Mr. Ahmed again. Yes.
I'm going to tell you about something, difference between traditional and flipped classroom. Concerning the teacher preparing, the time the teachers spent in the traditional method, I think it's the same time that teachers spend during the flipped classroom.
Because yes, during good point.
It's the same time, so it's not an advantage of the flipped classroom. It's a classroom because during the traditional teaching, teachers spend time teaching something, and in the class, the flipped classroom, the teacher spends the same time but preparing the material, the videos and material that students are going to use at home to learn. So it's
but it's not the same rule because in the traditional one the learner is better, but in
I'm not speaking about the role of teacher or student. I'm just speaking about the time for the teacher. The time the teacher spent in the traditional ways is the same time that they spend in the flipped classroom because they spend more time. Of course, they don't spend time teaching, but they spend the same time preparing the materials. So it's not an advantage of the flipped classroom.
Okay, thanks, Mr. Ahmed. Good point of view. Also, Ms. Iman Hassan said here that flipped classroom is based on learner, which is active to autonomous learning. The teacher role is to clarify the misunderstanding points only. Also, Ms. Fatma, developed learning, learners are active and independent learners. Dr. Lubna Shams, developed learning, students taking responsibility, interacting meaningfully and often with their instructor and peers, and getting and giving frequent feedback. They require deeper understanding of the content, how to use it. Okay, Dr. Ladwa, the slide isn't clear.
Yes, sure.
Can't you see? Can you see the slide? Can you see the slide?
Yeah, the slide is clear. But
okay, but it's not moving.
This is a student activity. The slide is blank.
Yes. Okay, I would like to add here. Yes, it's yes, just the title because it's an activity and you are just telling me the answers, okay? It's moving right now. Okay, who would like to add? Okay, so let's move together. In a comparison between the traditional model and the flipped classroom, we can divide them into three phases: before class, during the class, and after the class. Before class, traditional model, students do nothing, okay? But in flipped classroom, students do reading or watch lecture prior to class. This lecture may be a video from a YouTube recommended video or a video designed by the teacher himself, okay? During class, students watch lectures given by the professor in the traditional model. But in flipped classroom, range of activities, discussions, or quiz led by the professor, but centered on students to consolidate understanding. After the class, students consolidate understanding in the traditional model, but in the flipped classroom, students further consolidate understanding and prepare for next class. Okay, is that clear? Okay, let's move to another point. How can we flip? What are the different or the main steps to flip? We have here six steps to know how to flip. Plan, record, share, change, group, and regroup. Okay, so as we can see right now, plan. What to plan? We can figure out which lesson we can identify as teachers, outline the key learning outcomes and lesson plan. Okay? This is on the part of the teacher and learner together. They can plan together. Then record. Instead of teaching alone as a teacher, I can make a video or I can screencast works or make sure it contains all key elements I would mention in the classroom as a teacher. Okay. Also some professors of education in Birmingham. That don't make a video just for the sake of making a video. You are not going to make a video, you are not in the television. You just want to shed light on certain points that the learner should do or should add or should follow or should understand before coming that will achieve your learning outcomes and fulfill the educational goal of your lesson. If making videos better facilitate your instructional goal, then go ahead. If you find that the videos you make are already suitable and achieve your goals and fulfill the learning outcome, go ahead and record the videos, design them, or recommend the videos from YouTube or other resources to your students and ask them to go and watch them, then come to the classroom to present or make activities, engage with each other. After that, sharing. Send the video to your students. You can send them via different channels. Office 365, Teams, Google Classroom, WhatsApp. We have a lot of platforms to use. Make it engaging and clear. Yani, ask them to watch the video, ask some questions to encourage them to answer them, try to ask them to do something, some tasks during watching the video. Explain that the video content will be fully discussed in the class in order not to waste the time playing all the day. And don't watch the video. No, ask them or tell them that one of their most important tasks is to watch the whole video. Okay. After that, change that your students have viewed the lesson at home. Okay, they are prepared and fully prepared to go in depth and understand what are you going to say, what are you going to ask them to do inside the classroom. So you are designing activities, more games, more discussions, okay, more CCQs, okay, flipped learning techniques, means and needs, flexible environment, learning culture, planned content, and professional educator. Yes, great, Mr. Muhammad Yusuf, thank you. Also, group. Number five, group. An effective way to discuss the topic is to separate in two groups. You should group your students in two small groups where students are given a task to perform. Then you can even give them a poem, a play, or make a video, etc., and ask each group to comment on, to reflect on, to complete, to make a play or something like this. Then regroup again. Ask them to regroup again. Get the class back together to share individual group work with everyone. I divide the class into other groups. I change the rules of the group. Then they share and they participate together in their experiences and their opinions. Okay? Yes, the slide. I can see the screen. Okay. What are the rules of teachers and learners in flipped classroom? Okay, go ahead. Who can answer? What are the rules?
Yes, please. May I share?
Who is it speaking?
My name is Shaima Muhammad.
Okay, Ms. Shaima.
Yes, the role of the teacher in the flipped classroom, I think he is a guider, facilitator, and a helper for the students. He can help students and organizer also to divide them into groups to share their knowledge that they have learned before. The role of the student is that students is a researcher for the information by himself. He can search for the knowledge and information, then come to the class and share it with
Great, excellent, good job, Salman. As you can see here, don't just flip the class, flip the teacher too. As you can see, can you see that the learner already done the vice versa? He thought that he's going to flip the teacher too. Okay, what do you think? Who wants to share? Who would like to share? Who would like to share? Fantastic. Yes, Mr. Ahmed.
Yes, Ms. Amani.
Yes, Mr. Ahmed. Go ahead.
I just want to ask a question. Okay. So, the role of the teacher here in the flipped classroom is first to prepare the material the students are going to use at home. And then in class, a teacher is a facilitator, as you said, as a helper, as a coordinator, guide. Okay, so is the teacher going to teach something in this approach?
Yes, he is going to be a student editor and the student guide. Knowledge, the learner is a knowledge producer, okay?
The teacher's role as an instructor, as a teacher, I think it's not an active one, because the teacher doesn't teach here in this.
He plays a role as an information provider, just to give them resources and a role model for them.
This is at home, during preparing the material. Okay, so what is the role of the traditional role of a teacher who used to teach something? So what is the role here of the teacher? So
The role of the teacher here is just like a mentor. You know, the mentor rule, planning before the lesson, and during the lesson, he's just watching and following some rubrics to apply to the students. How do they work? He gives them advice and the elicit evidence is from the students that they already learned it. They have already achieved the learning outcome. They can make sure.
So from this point, let's move to another point. So the teacher prepares the material for students to use at home.
Yes.
So, and teach students learn at home from these materials, right?
Yes.
And when they go to school, they practice what they learn, and the teacher facilitates everything. So in this approach, here you rely too much on the student. You trust the student that they are able to understand everything they learn, and this is not reliable. It's not reliable to think that or to trust that students will learn everything. And I think it's another disadvantage of this approach.
Yes, and as you know, that everything in life has two sides, merit and demerit. Some of the demerits of this approach is that it's so dependent on the teacher, on the learner, okay? Sometimes it's not it's not good to depend on the teacher mainly. He may not the doer of his activities. He may not. He may depend on some of his students, some of his friends to help them without understanding anything. Okay, so he appears that he is doing this, but he didn't do it. Just depended on other people. That's what you mean. Okay.
Ms. Amani, please, may I add something?
Okay, go ahead.
Yes, sometimes not all the students come to the class and they prepared the knowledge before. Maybe them I tell them, please go and listen to the videos and try to write your questions. Then they come to the class and they didn't do that. So in this case, maybe the teacher can reteach the resource or the knowledge inside the class.
No, you just ask them to go. Each student can learn at his own pace. Say that one of them is ill or can't get the resources or whatsoever, for any other reason. So he is asked again to understand or get, to then come together with those students who couldn't come or who didn't couldn't understand or couldn't get the knowledge, enough knowledge, okay, come together and practice together at their own pace of learning.
But how can be accurate that students do that? Maybe we can do some quizzes. Maybe we can do some assignments first of the class. Mm-hmm. To be sure that they revised the knowledge at home and they studied the lesson before?
Yes, you can, all the activities and the practice inside the class, okay, after the pre-phase, depends on what they have learned or what they have studied of recommended resources on the part of the teacher, okay? So I design other quizzes, other assignments. I can send them or I can help them online, not only on site. Okay?
Yes, thank you.
And it's one of the advantages of flipped classroom, that the teacher can interact and be in contact with the learner all the time. Okay?
Question?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, what about slow learner? How can they reach the knowledge?
Okay, as we said right now, that the teacher can interact or communicate with the learner all the time using different platforms, different channels, okay? So he can give them some more clarification, some more questions. He can divide the lesson into smaller parts or smaller points. Okay, in order to make the students able to go or cope up with the different stages of the lesson, so he can take care of the learners outside classroom. Okay.
Yes, Ms. How can he?
Amani?
Can he? Sorry. Can I complete?
Yes, okay, go ahead.
Okay. Can you organize their ideas in the classroom and make at the end of the class, can he summarize for the slow learner?
Yes, he can summarize or make a wrap-up, ask them to summarize what they have learned. Okay.
Yes,
thank you.
Amani?
Yes, Mr. Ahmed, go ahead.
You said that the speakers just right now said that what about slower learners?
Yes.
Okay, Andy, you said one of the slides you show something called differentiation.
Yes.
Okay, so slip the classroom is has a good point of differentiate. So the teacher can prepare different material for the same topic according to the different level of students. This is very good.
Yes, as we said, they can interact or communicate with the learners via different channels and make it simple for them.
Okay, so differentiation here means that the teacher is going to prepare different materials, different of different levels of understanding, and so this will take much time of the teacher to prepare, and this can be this. I think this is a another disadvantage of this approach.
No, it can be at the same time. On the other hand, be an advantage because every learner can learn at his own pace of learning.
Okay. So okay,
thank you, Mr. Ahmed. Okay, let's move to another slide and see what are the different roles of the teachers. Okay, as we all said here, student assessor, mentor, learning facilitator, on the job role model, teaching role model. Okay. Yes, Mr. Mohammed Youssef says the educator guides the students as they apply concepts and engage creatively in the subject matter. Okay, 5 minutes left to the second session. So let's move. What are the different roles of the learner here at home and in class? At home, he is an instructor as lecturer. And knowledge acquisition, okay, he seeks knowledge and he is self-regulated and he has new content videos, technology use, and he is also makes flexible time and place. And in class, he is an instructor as a facilitator, knowledge construction, active learning, and collaborating learning, fix the fire in the place. Okay, let's move to another spot. What are the pros and cons of flipped classroom? As Mr. Ahmed Hawater cleared and said before, so advantages of learning, making learning central, learning rather than teaching, fosters independent learning, provides increased individualized attention, and also, just a minute, promotes peer interaction and collaboration skills, encourages higher student engagement. Also, there are disadvantages, as Mr. Ahmed also clarified, increased LCD screen time, online distractions, decreases a human element, digital divide, some control, reliance on technology. Okay, so this was our session today. Considered as the orientation session for what is learning today. If you need to ask any questions, just ask before finishing this session, which will have only 4 minutes.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
Mr. Said, can you hear me?
Mr. Said, yes, go ahead.
Okay. In fact, I'm going to go with the side of Mr. Ahmed Hawadri when he said that there are many disadvantages about this flipped classroom. What I mean in 3 points and in short as for the time, I think that flipped classroom increases the time spent by students on computer screens. Agree or disagree?
Can you repeat it again?
It increases the time spent by students on computer screens, and I think this is disadvantage.
Yes, I said this. Okay. If you come back, that I said that there are two sides for flipped classroom: advantages and disadvantages. But some of the advantages. Yes, Mr. Ahmed, go ahead.
Okay, Mr. Mani, you spent a lot of time talking about the advantages, but you spent only 2 minutes, 3 minutes speaking about the disadvantages. So I think this is unfair. This is unfair, Mr. Mani.
Okay.
You know that the flipped classroom will double the efforts this we do. So we will spend a lot of time preparing material, and then when after school, we will spend more time with the students online. And so this is so exhausting. And you know that there is a unit in secondary three called the work-life balance.
Yes, I know that, but I would like to remind you that there are only 2 minutes left.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Amani. You have done a very good job today. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's me to thank you for everybody, Dr. Heba, Dr. Radwa, Ms. Heba, Ms. Shaima, and Dr. Iman Hilal, Dr. Heba Said, everybody who thanked me. Really, it's me who should thank you for having a time with you today. Really, I enjoyed your session. Yes, the PowerPoint. If you need the PowerPoint, my dear, you can visit our platform and also it's a recorded session. You can find it on our channel on YouTube, Azhar Mentor.
Ms. Amani, thank you very much for this session. Please, I wanted the slide before the advantages and disadvantages.
Okay. Before the advantages.
Are you done, Ms. Amani?
By the way. Yes, that's what you want?
Yes, before yes.
You just have 1 minute, please.
Okay, Mr. Saeed, I'm really watching. Okay, thanks for everybody here. And if you need any questions, you can ask, you can, the discussion can be extended there. Yes, Mr. Saeed, can be extended there via our platform, and you can join us. Thanks, Dr. Lokna, for your joining today. It's an honor. And Mr. Said, Ms. Rania, everybody who attended, Ms. Iman Hassan, everybody, Mr. Ahmed Soui, you are all welcome. And I hope that I can provide you or exchange information with you, as you are all distinguished. Thanks, everybody. See you, inshallah, next time. Thanks, Ms. Ami. Assalamu alaikum.
Hi, Ash. No.